Hi Aries, this is Jennifer from Soul Source Tarot, and I'm going to be doing your October 9th through October 15th weekly love reading. This is intended to be a love reading. We will see what comes up. I have pre-shuffled these three decks for you. I'm just going to shuffle them a little bit more. This may or may not resonate, as it's for hundreds and thousands of people. I want to let you know that I have created a live feed page on Facebook if you want to go there and join. We are encouraging other readers, other talents, spiritual talents, to go and share their gifts with others and their knowledge there. And also people that are seeking guidance to engage with any healers that share. The link will be below. The name of it is Spiritual Guidance Live Feeds. It is a group on Facebook, and it is private. Okay, so it's closed. It's a closed group, so people can't see the posts unless they're part of it. This is for Aries, the week of October 9th through October 15th. There will be lots of free readings there, mini readings. They won't be as long as the private readings, but they will be mini readings. I think there's been some delays, and I think there's some changes to plans, okay? I think a lot of you are refocusing on things. I think there's a false entrapment somewhere in your life at this time. You're feeling falsely trapped somewhere, and you just want to get away. All right, I'm just going to get the rest of the cards, then I am going to zoom it in. Something is over or just about to be over. We have the Ten of Swords, and I know a lot of this has been going on for a while, Aries. I think that there's an ending in sight, and you're getting real close. Real, real close. But I think, you know, you have this fear. You have this fear, but, you know, there's a fear of something, but you know it isn't right, okay? And I know that you're ready to move on, because I've been doing your readings for a long time now. So a lot of you guys are definitely ready to take action and move on to a certain spot. I'm not sure where that is. I think you've been fighting a battle, and it may be inside, might be in your head, might be with another person, might be in your home, might be at work. You're fighting something that is unnecessary. It's like unnecessary drama. It's unnecessary conflict that you can walk away from at any time, and you've just been being stuck in that situation. We do have the Two of Wands here that tells me that it is just about decision time, and that this just keeps going on and on for you, because a lot of you guys have been, hesitating with making your move, all right? You've been hesitating and just you're scared of the change. You've been resisting the change for some unknown reason. You're very scared of the unknown. But I see that you really, really want to walk away, okay, from a situation. You want to leave it. There's unnecessary drama, okay? There could be some words of, some words of negativity coming your way, or there could be negativity in your life with another person, could be at your job. And I think that it's really controlling you. I mean, it's controlling your happiness, making you so that you just can't live in your happiness. I think that a lot of you have probably lost a lot of your excitement, and that you're trying to regain it. You're trying to refocus. You may be seeking guidance from above, or seeking guidance from a counselor. Or if you're not, you may want to consider it. But I think you are. If you're watching this video, you're definitely seeking the answers. We have the Hierophant here. This says, be sure to listen to your inner guide, because that's where most of your answers are going to come from. They're going to come from inside. And if you ask for guidance from above, the answers don't always come immediately. You might get them a day or two later. So just wait for them to come. You are going to have a little bit of patience. And I know that's not always easy for Aries. All right. But I think you're really, really close to this ending. All right. A lot of you have really thought about it. There's a situation that needs to end, and you know it, and you just need to take that next step, okay? And I think it involves walking away from something that is causing you unnecessary drama. I think you feel trapped in a situation, and you're kind of scared of the unknown, so you're just not moving forward. But you're thinking about it a lot, trying, you know, thinking, and it's just about decision time, all right? Now, this definitely could be related to a move. Some of you could be thinking about moving, and this can be away from a job, or it can be away from a home, or making a significant change to your home. Maybe somebody's moving in, or somebody's moving out, or you're upgrading, whatever the case may be. But I think that for many of you, you're thinking about moving on and changing your establishment, your family life, or whatnot, whatever it is. For many of you, that's what the case is, okay? I think your home life might change pretty drastically. And one of the reasons why you might be stuck is because of financial matters, okay? Because you're, you know, right there, it's stable and secure. So that may be one of the reasons why you haven't made the move yet. We do have a couple of twos here. It is absolutely, positively decision time. You have been focusing. You have been going within. You've been begging for guidance, I believe, you know, and begging for the answers to come, and the strength and the knowledge and the wisdom, okay, and the confidence, all right? I think you're just really trying to build up your confidence so that you can actually make this move, because you're trapped in a situation that I don't think you really want to be in anymore. And I think that there's changes on the horizon, but you really don't want to go through the chaos of the change, okay? But once you do, things will happen fastly. Once you take the step in the direction that you want to go to free yourself, because you can free yourself at any time, you can. Once you take that step, things will progress very quickly. You know, I don't think that you'll be stuck, you know, things are going to improve quickly, all right? Because once you get the Ten of Swords and the Ten of Pentacles, these are completions. Something new starts. It's an ending of something so that something new can start. And with the Eight of Wands, it's going to happen pretty quickly, all right? You do have Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio here. You have Taurus. You have yourself, Aries, and then you have Leo and Sagittarius. And you have the air signs, Libra, Gemini, Aquarius. I think a lot of you are falsely trapped. Perhaps, it could be with a water sign. Could be any sign, but we specifically have you feeling trapped with this. Could be the water sign is significant, you know, and it Pisces, Scorpio, Cancer. But I did name off the others, so it could be any one. There's definitely some challenges, all right, ahead of you. But you're going to have courage and confidence to do it. And you're going to have to really, really focus. I see a lot of focusing here. Whether you have been doing it or you are going to be still doing it, you know, I see that a lot of you are like dreaming up a new plan. There has been delays and you've been delaying it. And I think I started out the reading with that. I think a lot of you, you know, really have this new excitement, this new adventure in your head, and it's very exciting, and you just need to do it. You need to act on your hunches, and you really want to, and you're eager to do it, but I think that maybe finances and money may be a factor, one of the reasons that you are stuck in a situation. But with the Hangman and the Devil, you're falsely stuck there. You don't need to be, and the Seven of Wands, you really don't need to be in this situation any longer. It's a false state of mind thinking that you're stuck because of finances. You can make it. You have the skills to do it, okay? Now we have three twos. Twos are about faith and trust, 222, okay? They're also about balance in choices, in decisions, in partnerships. So I think for many of you, you know, there could be a change in a partnership. And I think you've really been thinking about it a lot. And you are looking for more excitement, okay? I think a lot of you are looking for more excitement. And I think maybe things have been just too boring in your life. And you just don't want to do it anymore. And I think when we have the Two of Wands twice, this tells me that you need to really, and I see that you've been focusing. The main thought at this time is you need to realize, where do you want to focus your energy? How long are you going to focus your energy on this boring time, on this time of no excitement, and this time of being stuck? You're going to focus your energy on that? Or are you going to focus your energy over here? Because over here it's kind of boring and unhappy, you know. Going within, feeling alone, not getting the attention you need. There's really no excitement. Over here, it's very exciting and daring and great. And it's like you start a new adventure and you're very excited about it. And then you have the Two of Wands on this side and you have the Two of Wands on this side. Where do you want the excitement? This is, like I said, twos are about decisions and choices. Do you want more excitement in your life, or do you want more of the same where you're at right now? Okay. A lot of you may be interested in somebody else. Could be a Taurus, Virgo, or Capricorn. Okay. So you could be, you know, the boringness or the non-attention could be coming, I'm just guessing here, from the water sign. Could be any other sign though. But we do have Taurus, Virgo, and Capricorn up there, and there's a lot of excitement. And this could represent you, okay? And this could represent you as well. So this is, it may be telling me that you are looking for something new, okay? And the thing is this is a new stability. It's a new security. This is this woman, it's a man or a woman, by the way, Taurus, Virgo, or Capricorn, is very motherly, abundant, responsible, disciplined, loyal, kind, and sexy, okay? So, and this is a man or a woman, and it is connected to you. So I think that a lot of you have dreams of something more than where you're at right now, okay? Okay, something needs to end. We have the Ten of Swords. Like I said, a lot of you are dreaming about this ending, but you're just afraid to take that next step. This says, if you do this, these are the outcome cards. Eventually, you're going to take the step, because this is an outcome position, and this one is too. And once you do, you will feel respected. You will regain your self-respect. You will feel like you have honored yourself, and people will actually recognize you and recognize your strength, okay? They'll recognize your strength. They'll recognize who you are and see you more clearly and how strong you are for making the decision that you made. This is going to be very positive. This is a victory, okay? So once you let whatever it is end that you want to end, you will be successful. You will be. This is a successful card where you're honored for what you have done. Okay? No disrespect here. You will be respected. So if you're worried about what the others are going to say, don't. Because in the end, you will be respected for the decisions that you have made. It takes strength to leave something that you feel trapped in. Okay, it takes a lot of strength and confidence and courage to do that. Okay? I think many of you are just looking for something more. You're looking for something more. There's got to be more to it than this. Like that saying goes, this isn't what I was looking for. You know, I want more adventure in my life, and this isn't doing it for me. So you might even ask somebody to step up to the plate, you know? Or you might just walk away completely. And a lot of you are past the point where you know you're going to walk away. You're going to move on to something new, but you just need to take the step. Okay? Because I see some completions here. You know, somebody is definitely moving on, either moving physically or moving on from something that they just, there's nothing left there. Now I'm going to get you three of these. Feel free to join the group if you want a free live reading. It doesn't mean you will get one, but it will be done every night. And if you are a healer, reader, anything spiritual and have gifts to offer, please go there and sign up and offer them. You're so close. You're so close to taking that step. You are. Nines are almost a completion, a 10. So this means that you are so close to taking the step, okay? Don't give up. Don't give up. Have courage and believe in yourself. That's what this card says. Have courage and believe in yourself. You will be successful. You will. You don't sit back and just do nothing. That's not who you are. How could you not be successful? Nine of Pentacles. This is where you become single, okay? Or you move on alone or something. Or you move on completely. This is somebody who does something on their own. And it usually is a widow, widower, divorcee, somebody who is separated. It's right over this false entrapment, okay? This is somebody spending quiet time alone, usually living alone for a period of time, or moving on alone, going, separating perhaps, you know, just to, because we have the Hermit here. I see that a lot of you just need time alone. And this will not resonate for everybody. Bits and pieces will. Okay? So, you know, some of you may have more desires, some strong carnal desires, sexual desires that aren't being fulfilled. And you know what? You're like, you know what? I need more than this. This isn't what I was looking for. So I'm just saying there's a lot of needs here that are not being fulfilled. All right? Maybe you're just ready for a change altogether. We have all these twos. They are about change. You're just ready for something new. Then we have the Six of Pentacles. New opportunities. Okay? This is new opportunities. This is a need to rebalance. Rebalance out your life. Okay? Bring the balance and the harmony back. So Aries, that's what I have for you. It looks like you just need to take another step. And until you do, you're going to remain stuck. I think the completion is right around the corner. Because we have if you look at the corners, there's a completion here and a completion here, right here. And it's because you're just not happy in a situation. All right? You're not happy. There's been too many challenges. All right? And boredom. And inaction. Okay? So that's what I see. I think that you have a lot of curiosity for what's next. All right? I think you're curious about what else could there be for me? This can't be it. Talk to you later, Aries.